Hi students, good afternoon everyone. Myself J. Srinu, lecturer in commerce, Convity Degree College, Gopalapur. Today we are going to start our third semester syllabus. So that in my first class I am going to explain what corporate accounting purpose syllabus. So in corporate accounting we have 5 units. So in those 5 units, first unit accounting for share capital. Accounting for share capital. In this unit, we have to see the share concept, rights issue, book building process, bonus shares, buyback of shares. Do you understand? Once again, I repeat, shares concept. Shares means shares forfeiture, shares cancellation, shares reissue. These are all the things we have to see. Then second one, rights issue. So in which manner we have to issue the shares, that is rights issue. Then book building process, then bonus shares. After that, finally we have to see buyback of shares in the first unit. In second unit we have to see the issue and redemption of debentures. Debentures means what? Debenture is an instrument containing information about shares, right? So, issue and redemption of shares. In this second unit, we are going to see the employee's stock option plan. Right? Then, convertible debentures, non-convertible debentures. So, what is convertible debentures and what is non-convertible debentures? And what are the differences between those convertible and non-convertible, right? That is second unit. So according to third unit, we have to see the valuation of goodwill and valuation of shares. In which way we have to value the goodwill and which way we have to value the shares. So in third unit, we have to see the methods, right? Different methods. Annuity method, super profits method. So that we have to see the methods of valuation of goodwill and valuation of shares. And what is the need behind that? So these are all the things we have to see in third unit. Coming to fourth unit, company final accounts. So what is the ultimate aim of corporate accounting? So corporate accounting's ultimate aim is to final the accounts of companies, So that in unit 4 we have to see the company final accounts. So generally we already know what are the different types of accounts in final accounts. Profit and loss account, balance sheet, trading accounts. Generally we have the type of accounts, right? So that likewise in company final accounts also we have profit and loss account and balance sheet as well as final accounts of companies through computers, right? So that is 14. Finally, in 15th unit, we have to see the entire picture of New Companies Act 2013. The New Companies Act 2013. What are the remedies? What are the provisions? What are the new things? What are the emerging trends in the New Companies Act 2013? Right? So in 15th, we mainly see the things relating to issue of debt shares or debentures. Again, we move the first unit topics. So in first unit topics, again we see in the 15th unit, but according to New Companies Act 2013. So these are our 5-unit syllabus. So you have to note down and prepare for yourself through this manner. That is best for yourself and it will be helpful to your examination, right? So this is our first class, then we can move the one by one concept in the next classes. Thank you everyone.